بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، we continue in our readings of the منظومة, is known as عقيدة السفرينية, explained by Sheikh Muhammad ibn Saleh al-Uthaymeen رحمه الله تعالى. As it was originally composed by the Nazim, the Imam Muhammad ibn Ahmed al-Safarini, rahimahullah ta'ala. We have been discussing the bait of the author, rahimahullah, which he mentions in this particular bait here, that to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belongs al-hayat and kalam and basr, and sam, and al-irada, and ilm, and qudra. And to Allah Ta'ala belongs life. With regards to his sifat, one of his sifat is the sifa of al-hayat, and al-kalam, which is speech, as well as basr, which is sight, and as-sam, which is hearing. And tonight we will deal with the next one, and that is al-irada. The Shaykh, he says, خامساً الإرادة. The author mentions, fifthly, the sifa of الإرادة. He says, والدليل ذلك قوله تعالى فعال لما يريد. فعال لما يريد. In Surah Al-Buruj, 16. Allah Ta'ala, he says that he is the one who does whatever it is, lima yurid, whatever it is that he wants, whatever it is he intends, whatever it is that he wills. وَقَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى وَاللَّهُ يُرِيدُ أَن يَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ. In Surah Al-Nisa, ayah 27, Allah Ta'ala, he says, and Allah Ta'ala yurid, connected to his irada, أَن يَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ, to turn to you and accept your repentance to him. وَقَوْلُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُبَيِّنَ لَكُمْ. And Allah Ta'ala, he also says in Surah An-Nisa, ayah 26, that Allah Ta'ala yurid لِيُبَيِّنَ لَكُمْ, that he will make things very clear for you, that he will explain and make these things clear to you. In all of these particular verses here, these three ayat, Allah Ta'ala uses the word or the verb yurid, meaning that this is an action. And from this action there comes the sifa of al-irada, of al-irada. وَالْآيَاتُ فِي الْإِرَادَةِ كَثِيرًا. وَالْآيَاتُ فِي الْإِرَادَةِ كَثِيرًا. There are many ayat in deal with the irada of Allah. The Shaykh is going to go into a detailed explanation of this, and it is very important, especially when we look at the three ayat that were mentioned and how they are to be understood. قال أهل العلم والإرادة تنقسم إلى قسمين. The al-irada, the irada of Allah, meaning Allah's intent, Allah's will, is divided into two categories. The first one is إرادة قونية. إرادة قونية. How would we translate that? We would say, if we were to loosely translate it, the universal will of Allah. The universal will of Allah. Now let's explain. وَهِيَ الَّتِي بِمَعْنَى الْمَشِيئَةِ. And it is the irada with the meaning of al-mashi'ah. And this is how we normally would translate, or how they get the translation rather, how they come up with the translation of translating al-irada as will. W-I-L-L. You follow jihad? By bin iradatun qawniya wa hiya allati bima'na al-mashi'ah. And al-mashi'ah means the will. From what? From the verb sha'a. Ma sha'a Allah. إن شاء الله. If Allah wills, whatever Allah wills. You follow Ali? Second one, إرادة شرعية. إرادة شرعية. وهي التي بمعنى المحبة. وهي التي بمعنى المحبة. Let's go back to the ayah. Or rather, let me translate that. And the iradatun shar'iyyah, the legislative irada of Allah. The legislative irada of Allah. And this is the one that carries the meaning of al-mahabba, what Allah loves and is pleased with. So there are two types of irada. One that is connected to the direct will of Allah. Whatever Allah wills, whatever Allah wants, right? Whatever Allah intends. And then there's the one with the meaning of everything that Allah loves and is pleased with. Let's look at this from in light of a Quranic ayah, the one that was mentioned previously. وَمِثَالُهَا قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى وَاللَّهُ يُرِيدُ أَنْ يَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ. Let's look at this ayah, brothers. In Surah An-Nisa, Allah Ta'ala, He says, and Allah يُرِيد from His irada أَنْ يَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ. I'm going to let you answer. Allah يُرِيد. يعني the irada of Allah here, Allah yureed and yatuba alaykum. He has the irada for you to repent to him so that he can accept your repentance. Which one does this fall? Which category? Is this the first one or the second one? Kauniyya or shar'iyya? Legislative, which is the second one, or kauniyya, which was the first one, universal? Shar'iyya? Who says shar'iyya? Who says kauniyya? You say kauniyya, universal. The brothers that say shar'iyya, they're the ones who are correct. فَهَذَا بِمَعْنَى الْمَحَبَّةِ وَلَيْسَتْ بِمَعْنَى الْمَشِيئَةِ. Because if that was the case, this one is the meaning of mahabba. So let's translate this. Allah loves and is pleased for you to repent to Him so that He can accept your repentance. He loves to turn to you in accepting your repentance. He is at Tawwab. You got it? You understand? This is how we understand it. وَلَيْسَتْ بِمَعْنَى الْمَشِيَةِ. It is not that Allah wills for you to repent to Him, because if that was the case universally, everyone would be doing what? Would be people of repentance. Right? Would be people of repentance. لِأَنَّهَا لَوْ كَانَتْ بِمَعْنَى الْمَشِيَةِ لَتَابَ اللَّهُ عَلَى جَمِيعِ النَّاسِ. Because if it carried the meaning of al-mashi'ah, just the universal will of Allah, then all of the people would be people whom have repented to Allah, and Allah Ta'ala turned to them and accepted their repentance. لَكِنَّهَا بِمَعْنَى الْمَحَبَّةَ تَتَأَلُّقْ بِمَشِيَتِهِ إِنْ شَاءَ تَابَ وَإِنْ شَاءَ لَمْ يَتُوبُ. But rather it has the meaning of al-mahabba, which is no doubt about it, Muhammad connected to his mashi'ah, because nothing can do what escape the mashi'ah of Allah. If he wills, he does what? Accept their repentance, right? If he does not will, he does not accept their repentance. طيب. ومثال الإرادة بمعنى المشيئة. And an example of الإرادة with the meaning of المشيئة, just universal will, قوله تعالى إن الله يفعل ما يريد. In Surah Hajj, Ayah 14, Allah says إن الله يفعل. Allah does ما يريد, whatever it is, تحت مشيئته, whatever it is that He wants, whatever it is that He wills, He does it. All right, this is بمعنى المشيئة. You follow? أي ما يشاء, whatever He does, He wills. بدليل قوله تعالى في الآية الثانية ويفعل الله ما يشاء. In Surah Ibrahim, which is the ayah that is connected to this, and Allah does whatever He wills. فهذه إرادة بمعنى المشيئة. And this is the irada with the meaning of المشيئة. And we want to take this شيئا فشيئا. We want to take this issue of al-irada piece by piece, because it's too much and it's very important. طيب. So this irada with the meaning of المشيئة. فالإرادة إذن قسمان. Irada is therefore divided into two categories. Number one is which one? Qawniyya.
What do we say in English? We just say universal. This means that this is what the universal will of Allah, in which no one can escape. No one can refuse. Everyone has to submit to. Right? Secondly, what is it? Shara'iyyatun. And that is the legislative, if we will, to translate that or say, the legislative will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You understand? يريد الله أن تقيم الصلاة في وقتها. Allah Ta'ala يريد. Allah has an irada for you to establish the salat in its time. What does this mean? Does this mean بمعنى مشيء or بمعنى محبة? This is just from me right now, my side note. What does this mean? This is not from the Shaykh, okay? It's mahabba. Tayyib Ali. Barakallahu fi. It's mahabba. Allah loves for you. It's pleased for you to establish the salat in its proper time. But we use the word what? Yureed, or the verb yureed. Bima'na irada, bima'na al-mahabba. Right? Tayyib. So it's divided into two. Where we're going to pick up with in our next sitting is the statement of the Shaykh making it even more clear to us. إِذَا قَالَ قَائِلْ مَا الْفَرْقُ بَيْنَهُمَا مِنْ حَيْثُ الْخُقُمْ. Very important. What is the distinguishing? What is the difference between the two from the standpoint of the ruling? From the standpoint of the ruling. Right? This is what we will, inshallah. Nuwasil, inshallah, we will continue in our next sitting based upon this one here. What is the difference between the two types of irada concerning the actual and a ruling? Tayyib. نكتفي بهذا القدر هذا والله أعلم وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Any questions?
I want to ask something which is not related at all.
Okay.
This is what I was discussing with the Sheikh.